cos 60 and TAB 0.236. So from here you have as x1 equal to, okay, from my calculation you have as x1 equal to 1.89 meter. You do the same thing for point AB, so you have SX2 minus B, which is SAX 0 equal to 16 cos 66, and the time is 2.59, and you have SX2 equal to SX2 20.72 meter. Okay, that's what I'm saying, that we want to solve problem from x direction, but the thing that we see from the equation, you notice that you have two unknown, which is time and displacement. So you have to take time from y direction, so you choose wisely which equation can give you that time. So you solve that one and get the time, put back in the original equation, you get s. Okay, so you only manipulate these three equations, okay, based on the thing that we know. 3 in x and 3 in y, 2 in s, because acceleration is constant. Okay, so we have solved the first problem, the first question, which is find the sx1 and sx2. Now we want to find the, what is the h max. Okay, what is the h max? So I'm putting back here everything, erase h max. Okay, so the h max is at point C. Where is my point C? Okay, h max. Okay, H max, which is also, this is S displacement in for point C in y direction. Okay, so here we have S max, okay, which is the displacement in y direction for point C. Okay, so choose from these three equations that give you S. Okay, so looking from this one, you only have two parts that have S, which is second one, V, and then this one. Okay, so we will choose from these two, which one that we can use to find the H max. Okay, so if I'm using this one, for example. Okay, S. For this one, should be the same. Okay, S. If I'm using this one, S at point, now we are analyzing from point A to point C. Okay, so for this one, which the H max, which is, this is what you want to find. Okay, H max, this is S. At point A in y direction 0, u, we have 16 sin 60 there, plus half a is always constant, plus t, so t, you need to find the t. Okay, from this equation you have two unknown, which is t and s. Maybe you cannot solve if I'm taking this one. Okay, v is the velocity at point C, u is initial 2as minus so. So the unknown is might be only here, the s that we want to find, and the other part might be u, v. Okay, but if you really understand from the introduction that I'm giving you for projectile, you already know what is the value of v. Okay, so I'm using this equation, v from point A to C, so vcy equal to VAY squared plus 2ASY, which is H max minus SAY. Okay, if you really understand the concept. Okay, first I will put the thing that I know. VAY, which is here, VAY equal to 16 sine 60 squared plus 2. A always downwards, so negative 9.81. Okay, the H mat that we want to find, minus SA1 at the origin, so this one is 0. So the problem is VC. Okay, so if you really understand, this component go upward, the velocity decrease once it go up, and take the velocity once it go down, and at maximum point, the velocity will be 0. So we know that directly here, the VCY equal to 0. This thing you need to remember and understand, it will not say to you from the question. If you know, you can answer the question. If you didn't know that one, you stuck. Okay, so you have to really know that one. At maximum point, the velocity will be 0. Okay, so if you are now, your only unknown is here, Hmax. So solve the problem, you will have Hmax. Okay, I've already calculated Hmax is equal to 9.78 meter. Okay, that's it for this second question. So you have that three equation, you can use for X and Y direction. So look at the possibility. So first one, you have to make sure that you draw the axis, choose one point as axis, and other analysis must always based on this point, refer to these two points. Normally we will take from the reference point towards other points, so AB, AC, AD, and so on. So that if you use this one, the velocity at the beginning you already know, and the distance, displacement, you already know, which is equal to 0. Okay, and then choose from that one. Okay, if you have two unknown, you have to choose from other question that can give you directly the answer. So you have to play around by these three questions, you can get the answer. Okay, if maybe for these three questions you cannot get the answer from Y or from X, you can go to Y direction first to check from the time, if the time is needed, and then go back to X direction, put the time, and then you get the answer. Okay, and the thing that you need to remember again is, the only acceleration exists is in y direction downward. So if our y is upward, so the acceleration here must be minus 9.81. Okay, the other thing is, at the maximum point, the velocity in y direction is 0. It will not be stated in the question, but you have to understand it will be 0. By that, you can answer all the questions. Okay, thank you.